Now, you may remember Natascha Kampusch, an Austrian woman who suffered a similar fate as the three victims in Cleveland. She has rebuilt her life since escaping from her captor in 2006, but says she can never escape the traumatic memories. Matthew Chance had an exclusive interview with Natascha today. He joins us now live from Vienna. I mean, quite a story, Matthew, that you have been following for the last 7 years, and then to have an interview with this woman all this time after her release.
Yeah, absolutely, and she's really changed quite a lot from 2006 when she first emerged from that cellar a short distance from the Austrian capital here, Vienna, into freedom for the first time in, what, 8 years. She was just 10 years old back in 1998 when she was abducted by someone called Wolfgang Pricklepill. He took her back to his house. He installed her in a cellar he'd had specially made. She didn't manage to get free for another 8 years. She was 18 years old when she came out, so she missed all those extremely important formative years as a teenager, just being kept in this cellar, sort of in the grip, being raped, being abused by this one individual, this one man. So the parallels with what's taken place in Cleveland are quite astonishing, and she's got a lot to say when we spoke to her today exclusively at CNN about what the women who were kidnapped in Cleveland may have been through and what they're likely to go through as well in the years ahead.
Well, what exactly happened on that day?
I walked down the street and I saw a man.
If anyone can understand what the Cleveland kidnap victims must have endured, it's Natascha Kampusch. She took us to the street in Vienna, where she herself was abducted, aged just 10. Like the women in Cleveland, she spent the best part of a decade torn from her family, imprisoned in her abductor's house.
When you saw that there were three women in Cleveland, Ohio, that had been through a very similar experience to yours, how did that make you feel?
I thought to myself, I'm very happy for the three women. Thank God they have survived their ordeal. They are certainly very strong.
This is the man who robbed Natascha of her childhood. Wolfgang Pricklepill kept her locked in his cellar for 8 long years. He raped her, then committed suicide when she finally escaped, aged 18.
It was an enormous feeling of joy that cannot be compared to anything else. You see all the possibilities laid out in front of you. The women in Cleveland should really try to savor this joyous feeling as long as possible.
I was very jealous of him. He had everything and I had only a small room.
But at the house where she was a prisoner, she's now the owner. It was awarded to her by the Austrian courts as damages. The property is an important symbol, she told me. Keeping it is her way of dealing with her past.
How do you get over it? I mean, a lot of people are going to be watching this situation in Cleveland and thinking about you as well, and wondering, you know, how do you ever get over an experience like this?
You live with it. You live with it in your head your whole life. You have to try to see the positive and look forward to the future, and to bury the hate you feel for the person who did this to you.
It is a sobering thought for the victims in Cleveland. Like Natascha, their captivity has been ended, but their ordeal may be far from over.
But it will be, I'm sure, reassuring, Matthew, for them to see Natascha Kampusch now in 2013, self-assured. She seems to be happy. I mean, you've spent time with her. Does she give any indication of her happiness these days or how she's living her life?
Yeah, well, I think, to be honest, she puts up a good front. I mean, it's remarkable, really, and admirable that she's been through so much. She manages to, you know, speak in that public way so frankly and candidly about what she's been through. But, you know, she is very shy when you speak to her. She's a little uncomfortable as well socially. She confided in me that she didn't really trust people and had trouble with that. And she doesn't have a partner either, even though she's 25 years old. At the same time, that has to be balanced with the fact, as I mentioned, that she's gone out there and given interviews. She's written a book, which has been selling a lot of copies around the world. And a film has been made about her as well. And so I think there's a sense in which telling her story has become very, you know, therapeutic for her, to help her get over her terrible, terrible experiences.
Yes, and extraordinary now that she owns that house that she was kept in for so long. Thanks very much indeed, Matthew, there, reporting live from Vienna with that exclusive interview with Natascha Kampusch.